In this video, we will talk about critical process diet Windows 11. We will show you method and step really quick in this video. And I'm pretty sure your problem will get solved because we have done all the research behalf of you so that you do not have to visit any other video or to the forum pages. So watch complete video. Method 1. System restore. Here you need to restore your system to the back date when your computer was working perfectly fine. For to do so, click on Troubleshoot, click on Advanced Options, click on System Restore, click on Next. Here you will see the date and the timing when your computer was working fine. So select that date and restore your computer to the back date. If you are not getting the restore point date here, you possibly have an option to select the box. Once you check the box, you will get more restore point listed in here. Select it and restore your computer to the back date. If you want to see after restore what application gonna remain on your computer and the application will be uninstalled from your computer, you can click on Scan for affected program. Once you do that, you can see all the changes. After that, you can restore your PC to the back date. Method 2. Scan with malware. On a lot of forum pages, malware usually causes this critical process died error on Windows 11 and on Windows 10. So scanning your PC with the malware is a good idea to remove all the malware from a computer. You can go to the safe mode with networking and there you can run the software so that you can remove all the malwares from your PC. Click on Troubleshoot. Click on Advanced Options. Here you need to click on Startup Settings. Click on Restart. Once you'll be on this page, you can see that Use Number Key or Function Key from F1 to F9. So we need to enter in Safe Mode with Networking. So press F5 on your keyboard. Alright, here we are in Safe Mode with Networking. You can see Safe Mode in all four corners. If you have any antivirus software or anti-malware software, you can run that software to remove the malware from your computer, or either you can go on internet and you can search for anti-malware software. Simply type download anti-malware and press enter. Scroll it down. You need to go to the Malwarebyte website and simply download their for home application. Click on free download and download it to remove the malwares from your computer. They will provide you 14 days of trial. Till that time, you can use their premium features. So that will help you out to remove the malware from your PC. Method 3. Uninstall Windows Update. Here we need to uninstall the Windows Update. For that, press and hold the Windows icon key and press R. And here you need to type Control and click on OK. Change the View By option to Category and select Programs, Programs and Feature. Here you can see View Install Updates. Here you can see the update recently installed on my PC. So click on Uninstall and make sure after you uninstall it, you need to pause the Windows Update. For that, you need to go into Windows Update and you will get an option to pause the Windows Update on your PC. If you are not getting pause option in safe mode with networking, then go back to your normal screen and you will get that option and you can perform the same without being in safe mode with networking. Method 4. Run the hardware and device troubleshooting tool. Press and hold the Windows icon key and then press R. Here you need to type a command msdt.exe space minus id space device diagnostic and press enter. Click on next. From here you can select the option which could be causing the problem and select enable. You can see that my PC found Windows Update config issue and it has been fixed. So you possibly get the information up there. You simply need to select it. If you're getting more than one problem up there, select it one by one and fix it. Method 5. Advanced troubleshooting commands. Here we need to go back to our advanced screen. So press and hold Shift key on your keyboard. Click on Windows, click on power icon and select restart. And make sure you do not leave the Shift key on your keyboard until you get this screen. Once you'll be on this screen, click on Troubleshoot, click on Advanced Options, select Command Prompt. Here you need to type some command, type one by one. Let me enter all the command. I have mentioned all the command in the description, so you can type that one by one. In chkdsk command, I have selected the C drive as I have installed the Windows in C drive. If you have a different drive, so you can select that drive as well and let it be run until it's finished. After running all the commands, simply restart your computer and check if that helped you to fix your problem. Method 6. Repair from bootable pen drive. In this method, you need to get a Windows installed pen drive, either Windows 11. If you have a Windows 11, then you need to get the Windows 11 bootable pen drive. Or if you have Windows 10, then you need to get Windows 10 bootable pen drive. After that, you simply need to connect that pen drive to your PC and you need to enter into your BIOS setting. And there you need to set your Windows PC to boot with the pen drive, and that will show you to install the new window, but you will get an option to repair your window. I'm showing you on your screen. You simply need to click on that repair option and that will repair your Windows error files. Method 7. Install fresh new window. If your repair method with bootable pen drive is not working for you, then you can simply install a fresh new Windows on your PC. As I have already suggested you what you have to do to set your Windows PC to boot with the pen drive. Once you'll do that, you will get an option to install the Windows on your PC. Simply click on install and you will get an advanced option. And after that, you need to select the same drive where you have that Windows installed right now and click on next, and it will show you a prompt that all the files you have related to your recent window will be forwarded to windows.old folder. Click on yes and install the fresh new Windows. And if you want to recover all of your data, then you simply need to go into your C drive, windows.old folder, and there you will find all of your file and the shortcut which was on your PC, a part of the application which was installed. I hope you will find our method helpful to you and your problem will get solved related to critical process died, Windows 11 or Windows 10. That's all for today. Thanks for watching.